Hi everyone, welcome to the new Seeker Elements set. We're still gonna be covering all of the mind-bogglingly awesome discoveries in the science and tech world. We've just got a fun new way to do it. And what better way to kick things off than with an update from the field of machine learning and robotics. If you've ever seen a baby kick and squirm involuntarily, or watched a small child clumsily try to do a physical task, you know that it takes humans years to develop fine motor skills. So it makes sense that intuitive, fluid motions are hard to get robots to do on their own, up until now. And get this, the robots are teaching themselves. A new robotic demonstration from a company called OpenAI uses something called machine learning, specifically a neural network, to allow this robotic hand to perform a complicated series of independent object manipulations. That means the motions you're seeing here, the robot is doing that by itself, without any input from or control by a human, and without any direct programming to perform each action. But first, what is machine learning? Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. It's getting computers to perform tasks without being explicitly programmed to do them. Take one of the most advanced robots we have today, a robot that helps us perform surgeries. This is a traditionally programmed robot that has to be explicitly told what to do every time. The programmer has to write, if this happens, the machine will do that for every step of the robot's action. For tasks where that would be prohibitively time-intensive, machine learning algorithms can be used instead. These are algorithms that you can expose to vast quantities of data from which they can learn certain criteria and identify patterns. So how is this applied in something like the robotic hand from OpenAI? In this situation, the main data sets are all of the different positions of the hand and the block. But the combination of all of these possibilities gives us way too many options for the robot to practice in real life so that it can learn each one. So instead, the researchers used a massive amount of computing power to simulate training the hand. They designed a virtual space in which the robot could experience myriad hand and block positions at an accelerated pace inside their computer model. The team estimates they exposed the robotic hand to about 100 years of trial and error experience in just 50 hours of this simulation. In addition to letting the hand practice, the researchers also randomized some aspect of the simulation, variables like the size and the slipperiness of the block, and even the force of gravity. While the simulation couldn't reproduce everything the robot would encounter when handling the cube in the real world, these variables made it more likely that the simulation practice would be useful in real-world conditions. Because of all of the variables involved, the research team used a kind of machine learning algorithm with a memory, based loosely on the way a human memory would work, making this particular algorithm a neural network, a kind of machine learning loosely based on the human brain and its logic structures. They then transferred all of this learned information to the real-life robotic hand, which is equipped with a set of cameras that can estimate the object's position and orientation. The end result simply asks the hand to manipulate the object in a certain way, say to reorient the block with its purple side up, and it'll do it. You ask for an outcome, and the robot can provide that to you with no further input because it taught itself the series of motions it needed to get there. As you can see, this robot developed motions that you may recognize from your own hands just by learning what motions were most efficient and effective at moving the block without dropping it. Other experts in the field of robotics and machine learning state that while this example is exciting and comparatively elegant, it's not necessarily new. It's also still quite limited to an object of convenient size in a hand that's facing up. So it's not dealing with as many challenges as a machine learning robot being asked to complete a task that would be useful in, say, an assembly line. So while robotics is still catching up to human capabilities, it is making strides. This work from OpenAI shows us that developing machine learning algorithms and neural networks could help us make more precise and dexterous robots that not only help us with things we don't want or can't do, but teach themselves how to do it. For more on AI, subscribe to Seeker and check out this video here about how AI is being used in the real world to monitor your data. And fun fact, some machine learning algorithms are also teaching themselves as they go. As they complete the task they taught themselves to do, they're also learning from their mistakes and evolving their own algorithm to make it more accurate, with some small guidance from human programmers. Thanks for watching Seeker.